Well, hello chaps, it's Commodore Graham here and welcome to the first episode in what should be a very long running series unless you all completely hate it. I'm going to be playing a heavily modified version of Fallout 4, where the look of the game is changed rather a lot, how the game plays is changed rather a lot, but we will find out all about that as we carry on. So let's begin. Main thing is, I'm playing in survival mode, but with some modifications to make it, well, not necessarily more difficult, but more fast-moving, deadly, and just entertaining to watch. And we'll sort of explain those as we go along. Some of the mods will be obvious, but now I think we're going to have the intro, for which I'm going to let run, because it's very atmospheric, although I may inject the odd quip here and there to completely spoil said atmosphere, but not this part.
War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen.
Actual things that happened.
He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
Also an actual thing that happened, crazily enough.
The world needed Armageddon. Instead,
Dr. Strangelove right there.
Something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power.
Atoms
People
for
enjoyed
peace.
Luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots. Fusion-powered cars.
Sweet!
Portable computers.
Apple Watch there.
But then, 21st century. People awoke from the American dream.
Children fought in
years
rubble.
Of consumption led to shortages of every
people in resource. Suits randomly ran towards factories. Dogs and
the
cats living together. Entire Chinese army parachutes
peace
onto the Himalayas for some reason.
Became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war. War never changes.
And cut to domestic bliss.
War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Honey, that was a poor choice of words,
absolutely,
don't you think?
Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
And character creation begins. Now, this may be included in episode 1, or I may cut it out and make it its own thing, because you may not want to watch me fiddling with dials. But let's begin. And now let's have a look from the outside. Okay. Fine. I think I'm going to accept this dude as my character. Done. Yippity-doo. And here we go. We're actually in the game again. The various different mods are adding themselves to the game. Let's have a little bit of a look around.
good morning, sir. Your coffee. 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection.
Nice. And
today's newspaper just delivered.
Okay. I bet the news is good. I bet there's nothing bad happening in the world. Is this supposed to be my newspaper?
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
It's always been my favorite broadsheet source of news, too. Hey, Nora. So, Codsworth, I'm going to talk to you instead of my wife.
Hey, Codsworth.
Enjoy your coffee, sir.
Well, it is 178.5 degrees. Uh-oh. Better the you than me, mate.
I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's a very caring robot. Let's have a bit of a look around. So, sugar bombs.
Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar.
All the sugars. Milk. I know what milk is. Come on. What we got in the fridge? Salisbury steak.
Salisbury steak. Graded A+.
Nice.
Nuka Cola. Ice cold.
Mm-mm. All the caffeines.
How can someone so small drink so much?
He comes for you every day.
Oh. That's dedication. Let's go and see Mr. Salesman, shall we?
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
Huh. Well, I know you come here every day, but what's Vault-Tec again? I'm just going to troll you, I think.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters.
Right.
If you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation.
Sounds pretty
you
slick.
You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Spoilers, mate, spoilers. Now, why is it so important right now?
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket.
Mind your fucking language.
Excuse my language. The big kaboom.
You better apologize.
It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think. If you catch my meaning... Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity.
Right.
I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Oh, the sense of wonder. So... everyone can come, right?
But there's room for my entire family, right?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally.
That's so
in
fucking
fact,
racist.
You're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't
robotist?
Want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event.
Siliconist.
Total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
It sounds amazing. Can't wait for the bombs to drop, mate.
Yeah, I can't wait for the world to end.
That's the spirit. Now, let's see.
Aha! So, here are my stats. This is a little different from Fallout New Vegas in that you start off with really crappy stats. So, the first thing I'm going to do is raise everything to 3, because anything below 3, I mean, Jesus, that's terrible. We're going to want a couple more points in intelligence so we can gain experience more quickly. Weapon accuracy in VATS, that's fairly important, to be honest. We're going to be using VATS a decent amount. Agility, number of action points in VATS. Oh, that's important too. Sneaking, That's going to be total health and action point drain from sprinting. So I think I'm going to add a couple to this, and I have one left. So I could either up my strength so I can carry some more stuff, which would make sense since I was in the military, or I could add something to either agility or perception in order to make me better at using VATS. Vault-Tec Automated Targeting System, I believe that stands for, if you're not familiar. I'm going to add one to strength. That's what we're going to go with. It's annoying not to be able to carry much stuff. Okay. Oh, no, no, no. And now my name. This is the name I decided upon in my dry run earlier. And I haven't deleted that save game, actually. So hopefully it's going to let me call him that. Okay. That seemed to work.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Congratulations on selling my future again to me, sir.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
God, she's so avaricious. Oh.
Mr. Chad. Sean.
Mr. Chad.
Refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
I'm a great father,
you
it's true.
Codsworth. Go on.
Okay. Oh, tell you what we should be doing. I want to turn the radio right down. Because I don't want to be able to hear it unless I wanna. I can still hear it. Strange. We want the master volume all the way up. Really. How odd. That must be sort of hard-coded radio that I can't get rid of. Let's carry on. Let's go and meet our infant. Now, does he really look like me? I'm kind of thinking that maybe he doesn't. Honey, we have something we need to talk about. I know you were saying that he has my eyes or some shit like that. But, I've seen you looking at the neighbor. I've seen you looking at Fred. You spend too much time together, and I'm starting to think... Well, what I'm saying is I suspect paternity fraud, honey. We're going to have to do a DNA test. I think that you may have cuckolded me. I may, in fact, be wearing the horns of the cuckold, as it were. And this will not stand. You look very nonchalant, to be honest, given all that I'm saying. Do you just not care? Well, I guess I'd better go and look after my wife's son. Hey, Sean.
How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
It's like I never said anything, isn't it? You just never listen. You know, when we have problems, we need to talk. Okay, I'll spin the mobile. Happy
hey,
now?
How's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Will it be like that night in the park a year ago with you, me, and Fred?
Will it be like that night in the park a year ago?
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
What's the deal, Codsworth?
Followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations.
You said "or no" before he said what it was. It's like you were responding to the subtitles or something, Nora. That's
oh my god.
That's clever.
We need to get to the vault now.
Oh, someone opened our door for us. Let's go, sweetie.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Okay, my wife seems to know where Vault 111 is. That's great.
Vault participants, head this way.
She's always been the organized one. Always organized in the camping trips with me, her, and Fred, actually. Fred's always loved camping. He's always been very enthusiastic to go on our camping trips.
You don't get
in. I'm going in. You can't shut me. Okay. I'm reporting this.
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home.
We're in the program.
We're on the list.
God, we're gonna die.
Infant.
We're gonna die out here.
Adult male. Adult female.
We're in the program.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good
luck, ma'am.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's gonna happen to all those people outside the gate?
They're toast, honey. Don't even think about them. You might as well not think about them as people anymore, because soon they won't be. It's sad. It's sad, but it's true.
Almost there.
Nice.
We're gonna be okay.
Bird.
I love you. Both of you.
We love you too.
Yeah, everything's gonna be fine.
Hold on!
Can't this thing move faster?
Oh god.
Yeah, I was just thinking that. Oh hey Annie, everything's fine. It all worked out okay. We're not dead. Presumably. This would be a bit of a weird afterlife.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
We're better than okay. We're great!
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
Look at these.
Yes, up the stairs.
Cowering citizens.
If we left a minute later.
No.
We'd all be.
Don't get caught up.
We'd be dead.
About that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Come on, honey.
Just this way.
That's right. You remember how to do stairs.
All new residents, please proceed in an orderly fashion.
This way.
Welcome home.
Step over to the table.
It's our new home, honey. How'd you like it?
A little female, but male.
Okay. Welcome. Pick up
female
a
female and
here you are. Head down the hall there.
Right over there.
Hi, dude.
Just step over to the table.
You sound way too comforting.
Over there. Take a suit.
Hello, madam.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
Okay.
It's down the hallway right there.
This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
Suit, then head down the hall.
This needs more potted plants,
our
to
home.
Be honest.
Everything we
Sir?
Had.
My mother and father down in D.C.
Less scary metal corridors.
Oh, God, honey.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
I know.
Forever.
We'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Fashionable as well as comfortable.
Okay.
Right? Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Yeah, how lovely. I'm almost glad there was a nuclear war.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
Hey, dude. Let me see that Apple Watch you got there.
Daddy's right here.
That's a nice pit boy. Vault-Tec brand? Yeah. Oh, what, honey? Oh, yeah, I've got a wife and a kid. Okay. Yeah, sure.
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There he is. See? Daddy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
Okay, you're the doc, Doc.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
I am relaxed. What are you talking about?
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In
oh.
5, 4, 3.
You forgot to put the heating on in here. Some indeterminate period of time passes.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
I'm thawing out. Hopefully I don't have massive internal damage due to the process.
This is the one.
Hey, that's my wife.
Open it.
If you want it, put a ring on it.
Turn it over. Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Can you please not play tug of war with my baby? That was a tad on the unnecessary side, evil-looking, mysterious figure. An indeterminate period of time passes. Well, shit.
Come on! There has to be a release!
But think about this, Chad Patriot. She's frozen right now, right? So if she's been shot, maybe we want to keep her frozen until we can get someone to... I mean, let's face it, like, probably she's had her brains blown out. There's nothing we can do here. But let's err on the side of caution, shall we? Let's not be rash. Oh, everything's thawing out. Drip, drip, drip. See, I could open it here, but what would be the point exactly? What's with this? Give me the infos. Cryogenic array offline. Premature termination resulting in system failure. Isolated, manual and remote overrides detected. Controls disabled. This may mean that everyone is thawing out, unfortunately. Life support. Offline. Premature termination resulting in system failure. Isolated, manual and remote overrides detected. Controls disabled. It's not looking good, is it? Pod occupant status. Okay, here's all the pods in this room, I guess. Nora and Sean. Status unknown. Pod door manual override engaged. Yeah, I noticed. There. Oh, Chad Patriot. That's me. What about this empty pod? That tells me nothing. Right. Moving swiftly on. Oh, incidentally, when I started recording this video, I forgot to set the overclock on my graphics card, so there may be a little bit more... It might not be quite as smooth as future episodes will be. I forgot to put that on my checklist before I started the episode. But anyway, let's get back to it. More pods in there. Oh, we cannot open this door. Let's start taking things. You never know what things you might need. Let's take all the things. Contact my Vault-Tec maintenance representative. I don't think there's too many of those around it. What? That was a weird looking dog. Okay. We may need a baton. That's something that may be quite useful. So, what we got? Cigarettes? I think I might need one after this. Ah! More cigarettes. Cigars? Such luxury. So let's take everything. Stim packs. Nice. Nuka-Cola. More cigarettes. I'm just going to be so caffeinated and nicotinated up, really, aren't I? Okay. We got to find out what's going on here. Right. Vault 111 security instructions. Confidential, security eyes only. Vault 11 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Security staff are responsible for maintaining installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with vault operations are capital offences. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force. Shit. This stuff's for serious. Operations Protocol Manual. Resident admittance. Upon activation notice from Vault-Tec, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. This is sinister. Oh, wait. Staff duties, that was next. So, what did the eggheads have to do? Members of the research team must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary and cognitive activity in particular must be recorded hourly. To be honest, there probably wasn't too much of that since they were frozen. But let's carry on. Maybe I'm injecting too much science into this science fiction. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension and must not interrupt suspension. So we're essentially expendable. We are not prioritized as highly as experimental results. Independent research is encouraged and left to overseer discretion. Security personnel. Security patrols to be carried out on a constant 8-hour rotation. Security priorities include monitoring for signs of intrusion, checking for atmosphere leaks, settling disputes among personnel, enforcement of regulations set forth by the overseer and by Vault-Tec. It's fairly standard. What was that again? Faculty services and maintenance. Due to the nature of Vault 111, personnel be expected to perform duties outside of their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. Also down to overseer discretion. All clear and evacuation. Ooh. Following a nuclear event, Vault-Tec will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all-clear notice. Upon receiving the all-clear notice, Vault-Tec personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault-Tec, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault-Tec will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. Mandatory shelter period. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault-Tec, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstance may Vault 111 staff evacuate during this shelter period unless receiving the all-clear message from Vault-Tec. Well, oh. Security logs. This looks important. So, October the 23rd, 2077. Oh, that's when the bombs dropped. God, it finally happened. The world's over. Barely got all the residents inside. Not everyone made it. Now it's just us and the icebergs. I don't get it. Eggheads tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment for a better future or something. I don't know. It just doesn't seem right that we were smiling at them all that time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them something? Not such a bad dude, seemingly. December the 25th, 2077. Christmas Underground. Got together with the rest of the security boys and support staff and had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy lad snack cake that wasn't too stale. None of the scientists came. Overseer wasn't there either. I just don't get them. They're hiding something from us? Another company secret only for the higher-ups? Whatever. Just a few more months until the all-clear is supposed to come through. Then we can start rebuilding. March the 14th, 2078. Only a few weeks left in our mandatory shelter period. Everyone's getting stir-crazy. Some people are even saying the all-clear signal is never coming. We can't stay here much longer, that's for sure. It's not just the fact that I've been staring at the same break room and bunk bed for over 6 months. It's the fact that we only have enough food left for another few months. Tops. The overseer keeps telling everyone to be patient. Focus on work. He's definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad is going on. I just know it. April the 23rd, 2078. The main door accessing the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the overseer's evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He has one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from a little makeshift checkpoint. Got invited into a meeting tonight. Support staffers and security only. Seems like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. Whoops. Last entry. No all clear from Vault-Tec is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. I almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. A handful of us confronted the overseer about opening up the vault. I never knew a man that small could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in his office along with the rest of the science staff. We're supposed to hand over any food, weapons, and medicine we have by tonight, or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everyone. It's time. One way or another, we're getting out of this vault. Whoops. Well, shit. Is there anything else here? No. There definitely wasn't, right? Well, where's that dog gone? Yeah, hello, little pooch. You look a bit chitinous for a dog, to be honest. Some breed I've never seen before. Right, where were we? Okay, then. Now we got to get out of here. Because if there was no food for them, then there'll be no food for us. Oh, it's another little doggy. I don't trust it much. And let's use vats to stomp it. Although I'm not sure how we have vats right now. Stomp! Because we don't have a Pip-Boy yet, and I thought that that was...
Giant roaches? What the hell?
Well, quite. Let's butcher it for its meat. Another baton. Do I need another baton? Let's take it. Why not? I can always drop it later. Right. I should definitely be picking up any bottles that I find. Carry water in, since we're playing in survival mode. Wonder glue. Wonderful. You never know when you might want to make a little toast at the end of the world. So there's another terminal right here, so I guess we're getting more story. Recreation terminal. Overseer memo. Top 10. Play tape. Oh, right, there are little mini games. Let's have a look at it. Red Menace. Start game. It's okay, that's how you jump. It's Donkey Kong, essentially. It's Donkey Kong with missiles. Let's see how we can... No! Ah, well, that was good. However, I'm pretty sure that sprite didn't hit my sprite. We're really not going to play this for too long. I'm going to... when we run out of lives... Oh, wait, what's this? Oh! Wait. I can't get up ladders now. Is it? Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can. Oh, yeah. Because I've lost... Ah, goddammit! Because I lost the power armor. Now, I'm not really sure how much use the power armor is if it doesn't let you get upstairs. Oh, that was close. Okay, how are we doing? We have a score of... Wait, what? That barrel fell down the stairs. That's cheaty. Okay, quit. Yes. So let's take that game with us, just in case we feel like playing that instead of playing, you know, Fallout 4 later on. Overseer memo. Remember, use of the recreational terminal is a privilege. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Enjoy responsibly. All of these people playing Donkey Kong instead of setting about the... Well, I mean, how much stuff will there be? Would there be to do in this place? Top 10. Oh, this is the top 10 scores in this game that is not Donkey Kong. Definitely not Donkey Kong. So, there wasn't anything in here. As far as I recall... Oh, well, we could have a sleep, I suppose. As far as I recall, there isn't anything useful in this room either. Oh, wait, though. we can fill we can just fill all of our bottles. I don't know how many we've picked up, half a dozen or something. Right, and let's have a drink just to make sure we're sufficiently hydrated for the road ahead. Well, that doesn't look at all threatening. I'll just edge around here. Right, I don't think I'm going to bother butchering that one. We got another friend. Nice. Did we get hit? And there's another one. Get wrecked, yo. Kill cam, fantastic. Hello, are you okay?
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Well, there's someone. At least there used to be someone. Uh-oh. More doggy friends. Uh-oh. I think I got hit there. There was a spurt of human blood. I can't actually reach him from here. Or from here. Oh, he's about to leap. Did I smack him down in time? Okay, we've taken very little damage. Adrenaline's increasing my damage. Stay awake and get more kills to increase the bonus. Sleeping will reduce it. That's an interesting dynamic. There we go. I got my little bit of health back there that I'd lost. So what is this? Is this the... no smoke. Is this the overseer's office or what?
Is this all that's left?
Clearly. But you know what else is left? 3 stim packs. And a gun. Fantastic. So, we were sorely lacking in the gun department. Happily, that is now fixed. What's in here? More cigarettes. I'm not going to be lacking for nicotine. Oh! More ammo. Fantastic. Got a feeling I'm going to need a lot of that. Another stim pack. Is there anything in here? Nope. The terminal there, I'll get to that. In here we have... Oh! Another gun? Why not, I guess? Cryolator case.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Huh. I can't do anything about that. Let's see if we can get at any more information here. Oh, this must be the overseer's office, right? I don't think I saw the overseer instructions before. Oh, wait. No, maybe I did. Oh, no. This is slightly different, I think. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation of blah, 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 blah. I've seen this stuff. But actually here... Your staff is also considered expendable. That's new. Insubordination or attempts to evacuate prematurely are capital violations. I think that's new anyway. Unused cryogenic pods are the preferred method for cadaver disposal. Now, the cryolator. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable on-demand form. That's a strange dream to have, but okay. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with this prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Operations Protocol Manual. Yeah, we've had that. Overseer's log. This is something we haven't had. Preparations. The final staff orientation is complete. All but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Vault-Tec's supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time, I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. So clearly they were planning to keep the residents in the pods for longer than a normal human lifespan. October the 23rd. Oh, the day the bombs fell. It's happened. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. I wonder if we'll be meeting Nordhagen. Was Nordhagen the sales rep? Probably not. Resident admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. And that was my family, I guess. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people. They must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. Systems malfunction. Strange issue today with pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out. I only hope their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Well, yeah, if you want to keep them for decades or even centuries. Supplies running low. There's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies were never intended to last much more than that. And despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. What do you press here? Oh, there. I just have to keep everything under control until the all clear. Mutiny. A faction led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. I've been too damn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed. Well, this is what happens when everything goes to shit. And, resources vanish. Open evacuation tunnel. The personnel evacuation tunnel is now open. Remind all staff to be orderly and follow shutdown protocols before exiting and resealing Vault 11. Please maintain all staff records and research. Report to your local Vault-Tec superiors for debriefing and further instruction. Well, your Vault-Tec superiors are probably long gone. Okay. Are we done in here? I think we're done in here. Oh. Gotcha. Oops, didn't mean to. Oh, there's another one there. I can just about see. And reload. Oh god. Well, if you can just. Oh god! Let's use VATS. That should do it. Lovely. Now we have all the rad roach meat we could possibly desire. Which ordinarily would be none. I've just... Oh. There we go. I've just discovered what rad roaches are. And apparently I already think it's a good idea to butcher them for their meat. This seems slightly unrealistic, but never mind. Okay. Oh, hello. And goodbye. Anyone else want some? Okay. What's this? Right. I think this was the door we couldn't get through before. Yeah. I remember that toolbox. Oh god! Ow. Well, that was not ideal. We took a fair old amount of damage there, unfortunately. Okay. The way out, hopefully. Oh, I always wanted one of these. I wonder if this is the doctor whose Pip-Boy I complimented earlier. Who needs an Apple Watch? This is clearly far more practical. $64K RAM. Nice. That's as much as the first computer I ever owned. Just to date myself there. Right now, there's some things we got to do. If I go to my inventory and aid, quick save. Right, what I want to do is hotkey this. Essentially, it's a mod that I've added so that you can save the game in survival mode without having to sleep in a bed. Because honestly, that's just goddamn ridiculous. I would never get anywhere if I wasn't able to save whenever I wanted. Just because survival mode is so difficult, and I've made it even more deadly with the mods that I've added. Bullet time. Oh. Whoops. No. I don't want bullet time to be on right now, but what I want to do is to hotkey that as well. I think if I hot... I meant to hotkey it to... The equals key, right? Come on. Now that's meant to work. let's see. Bullet time, hotkey. Right. Oh, right. I just had to click on it. So now, with the key mapping file that I installed, I should just be able to press the auto move key, which is X, and get bullet time. Great. Right, so let's see if we can save the game. We can! Okay. Let's get this door open. So, everything's working according to plan, at least as far as, you know, all the mods that I've added. Sure thing. So, what I'm going to do now is save the game once again and stop the recording so that I can run about the place taking screenshots all over to see what's the best thumbnail image I can get for YouTubes. I'll come back and start recording once I've done that. Well, hello chaps, there's that all sorted out. I just needed to enable a couple of mods for when we go outside that I didn't want running whilst the intro was. I also went and had a bit of a run around the complex, found myself a thing or two, nothing of massive consequence, but I found a new Vault 111 jumpsuit. There doesn't seem to be any difference in the stats, as you can see. Did I pick anything else up? Oh, I'll tell you what I did. I enabled... where is it? If I go into my settings, holotape collection. I enabled eye hood or immersive hood, which is a mod by Gopher. And what this does, if I come back out here, put my gun away, you'll notice that I'm seeing nothing except my character's view. Now, I've got a couple of hotkeys I can use to change that. There we go. I can bring the hood up there. I've got it set up so that my action points don't show up until they drop below 80%. And various things will automatically pop up when you need them, according to rules that you set in here. So when the compass activates, when the health bar activates, which I've also got set at when my health goes down to 80%, when I can see my action points, when my crosshair becomes available, and other things too, the most notable of which was when my ammo count comes on, which I did have as constant. It was like always on, at least when I have a gun drawn, but I changed it to when only when I'm in combat, or I toggle it with the eye hood toggle. Explosives count always on. Yeah, I guess I'll leave that alone. That's fine. But I didn't change very much. So yeah, I can either activate the entire hood, or I can activate just the compass whenever I want with different hotkeys. But yeah, what else happened? I found a couple more bits of ammunition lying around, stuff like that. That's pretty much it. So let's get ourselves out of this damn vault, shall we? See what kind of ruin the outside world has become. Okay, yep, I don't need to change my name or my appearance or my attributes, so let's just leave.
Enjoy your return to the surface.
Share and enjoy. Happy service. Happy service? Happy surface. with an F, you see. Okay, so we have escaped, but shall we survive in the bleak, harsh wilderness that presumably lies up here? Beantown Interiors. This is a mod which gives interior spaces to a lot of buildings that you just can't get into otherwise. Just adds a certain amount of extra content. It's pretty nice. The fateful moment. Well, well, there's my town. Everything's covered in snow and frost. There's a definite nip in the air. How can this be? Okay, then. Well, next episode, we shall go down to our home, see what's become of it, see if anything's left behind, see if we can find our son, or rather our wife's son. That's all we really know for certain, as mentioned earlier. and that's it for now. Such cliffhanger, many suspense. So, take care. Bye-bye for now. do click the like button if you liked the video. It helps out rather a lot. Leave your suggestions, shocked exclamations of exasperation and whatnot in the comments section below. And subscribe if and only if you'd like to see more. Ta-ta for now, chaps.